Thank you for plugging into this Family Life News podcast, streaming issues-driven, family-focused news. And welcome back to another edition of Hometown Heroes on Family Life. I'm your host, Bob Price, and this week's guest, Eileen Chapman of Bloomsburg, Pennsylvania. She heads up a one-of-a-kind ministry that's meeting needs by filling gaps the government can't reach. Just tell us a little bit about what Agape is and how it got started.
Well, Agape is a faith-based, non-denominational ministry. We serve Columbia and Montour County residents. We have expanded greatly since 2008 when we formed and then 2009 when we actually opened.
Your website, Eileen, says that you kind of exist to fill the gap that exists between people in need and the community services that are available there in Columbia and Montour counties. So explain how that works a little bit.
Well, we have nonprofits and government human service agencies who try to help the needy, but they have regulations that prevent some from getting the relief that they need. So we're much more flexible. Mm-hmm. We get lots of referrals. We are, in some extent, the human services agency for Columbia County. And about a year and a half ago, we bought a 100,000 square foot building with offices. It's a godsend. It really is.
That's wonderful. And you are pretty good at this. And I know you probably don't like to brag on your organization, but a few years ago, Columbia County Chamber of Commerce named you their not-for-profit of the year. So you guys have been recognized for the good work you do. What are some of the services that you provide there in the Bloomsburg area?
We have the warehouses, I won't say full, but we can help people that are moving into new residences for them and they have no furniture or they need some kind of furniture. We have large appliances like washers and dryers and refrigerators, stoves, and that kind of thing. We have small appliances like crock pots, you name it. Sometimes we have them, sometimes we don't. It depends on the donations received from the community. And then we spray everything that is cloth and then hand it out to those who are in need.
I wonder, just personally, Eileen, why do you feel so called to this sort of a ministry?
Well, there are days I ask myself that, but I just think it's a calling from God. I want to help the community from the standpoint of using my experiences and skills that God has given me, and retirement just doesn't fascinate me at the moment.
I
do this as a volunteer because God has blessed me with so much that I need to return.
Yeah, as you know, the country has gone through a little bit of an economic downturn, whether it's caused by the pandemic or inflation or supply chain issues. I'm wondering how that's trickled down to you in your ability to provide assistance to people in need.
Well, over the last 2 to 3 months, it's really impacted us. We used to have lots of food. We no longer have that. And our clientele has increased from about 375 up to now probably about 800.
Wow.
And so we have to be careful how much we give each one. Now, everybody gets the same thing, but we have run out of food.
Yeah.
Financially, it's less donations, but it's still coming in. People are very generous despite the situation. And one of the things that we have really, really struggled with is helping clients with mental health issues.
Yeah.
It's just unbelievable, absolutely unbelievable, the mental health issues we have and no place to send them.
Thank you for being there and filling that gap that is so needed there in north central Pennsylvania. You have all this information on your website. I'm just curious as to how you're funded, how you're able to keep your doors open and providing this service to so many people for so many years.
Basically, it's been the support of individuals, churches, organizations, businesses, and we got great response from that. And so we appreciate $5. We appreciate $1. Most of all, we appreciate prayers and volunteer service.
That's Eileen Chapman of Agape Ministries in Bloomsburg, Pennsylvania. She's meeting needs by filling gaps that the government can't reach. Join us next week as we search for your home, your town, your hero. It's Hometown Heroes on Family Life.